Anybody that wants to take it to a step to that next level, take him out. If he comes in and I have an opportunity to throw him out, I will throw him out. Because anything that he has, you have the ability to take from him if you take him out.
This man is always a favorite whenever he enters the ring, but this time there are 29 other strong contenders. I'm delighted to speak to you, Mr. Lashley. How confident are you heading into this match?
I am extremely confident. Like you said, there's 29 other people in this match, right? I ask you a question. Which one of those 29 do you think can beat me? That's the question for you.
Oh. That's a very difficult question to answer for me, but maybe I can toss some questions to you about some of the favorites in this match, some of the other people who are in this match. One of the big things that everybody is talking about these days in the wrestling fraternity is the return of CM Punk to WWE. And I mean, aside from you, some might say he might be the favorite. What was your reaction when he came back?
I was like, oh, that's cool. I know CM Punk. I don't know him really well. I always make my opinion on someone based on my interaction with him. And ever since I've known CM Punk, every time when I've talked to him, I've always had positive conversation, everything like that, nothing negative. What if he says something behind my back to someone else? I don't know about this. I don't know. I don't know. I don't go into those kind of dramas. So he's back. And with that being said, I think he's a possible favorite because everybody knows that he has his history and his apparent interaction with the crowd. So I think he's a favorite. I don't think he's the favorite. I think he's one of the favorites. I don't think he's the favorite. The favorite could be anyone. Cody, Drew, myself, world champions, former world champions. I think anybody has the opportunity to step up there. And I think the biggest thing and the best thing that we can possibly do is have it be a surprise.
Absolutely, absolutely. And what happens, I mean, if you are in the ring and you see Montez Ford or Angelo coming towards you, is it every man for himself?
I'll say, get in, let's throw out Punk. And then we're going to throw out Cody, and then we're going to throw out Drew.
Man, speaking of surprises, I mean, there was a video package on Raw, and Hulk Hogan said, "There's one more in me." Maybe there's one more on in me. I'm paraphrasing. If he comes in, what would your reaction be?
Who?
Hulk Hogan.
Hulk Hogan?
Yeah.
Oh, if he gets in, I'll throw him out. You want me to give him a high five? I'll throw him out. That's what it's about.
And there is one big name that we are probably missing out on. I mean, he made a surprise appearance at the start of this year, and now he's on the TKO board of directors, Dwayne Johnson himself. Do you think he could be a part of the Royal Rumble? And generally, what was your reaction when The Rock returned to wrestling?
Oh, that was incredible. I mean, it's The Rock. Probably one of the biggest names in everything right now. So when he comes back, that always brings a tremendous amount of views. And you know what? Anybody that wants to take it to a step to that next level, take him out. If he comes in and I have an opportunity to throw him out, I will throw him out. Because anything that he has, you have the ability to take from him if you take him out. So, I mean, he has a, it's not going to be a cakewalk for him. But, I mean, of course, once again, another superstar from, like, we have so many great superstars in this business that were former world champions. And then just having that huge name and that huge fan base, it's going to be hard to beat a lot of the guys in there because that's the energy that they get. They get it from the crowd. If you're running out and people give you an ovation, like, they're going to get rocked. man, you can move mountains in that case. So that would be awesome for him coming. But of course, like I said, I'd be one willing to take him out if I had that opportunity.
One of the biggest matches that everybody's talking about, aside from the Royal Rumble match, is Roman Reigns taking on three people, not one, not two, three people. And he doesn't have to be pinned to lose the title. Do you think it's finally time for a new world champion? Maybe Randy Orton, maybe somebody else?
Man, you know it would be crazy if he does retain it. He's beaten one person, he's beaten two people. Now he's beating three people. And I'm telling you, Roman is on top of the world right now. And it rightfully should be. He's done big deal. He's done big things for the company for a long time. And he's proven his dominance. This is his next biggest challenge. He beats three people. If he beats three people, that's another like notch for his belt. One thing he hasn't done with this title reign.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Which brings me to my next question, in fact. I mean, there are three of you, and, you know, with Solo and with Jimmy, there are three of them. Do you think a stable versus stable match would be interesting?
I would love it. I would love it, and it should happen. It absolutely should happen. So, whether it happens or not, I don't know. We have our group, and our group is just starting to get a little bit of steam under us. And once the team gets rolling, because at the beginning, you know, you got to work out the tweaks. We've had some ups and downs, and I think some of the downs is because we weren't doing what we should. You know, you come out there, you got to be prepared to fight. We've gotten jumped behind our back several different times. So now we have to get to the point where we're actually watching out for each other. If we watch out for each other, watch our sixes, that's what we say in the military, and we make sure that we do what we need to do, it would be no problem. Because look at it. I just got jumped from behind by Santos and his group. Now think if I were to be the one going against Logan Paul, a guy that doesn't come to the show, just runs around with our title and talks a tremendous amount of trash. If I was the one to get him, I'd take that title away from him and I'm there every day. So that would have been very interesting. Of course, I would have had to get by Kevin Owens and another superstar, like I said before, on our roster, former world champion that has all the potential to do big things also. So that's the funnest thing about wrestling right now. We're in a really, really good time and there's all kinds of possibilities.
Amazing. I've just been told to wind up my absolute final question. A lot of people have been wondering, you know, the Judgment Day has Rhea Ripley. Could your faction, I don't know if it is called the Pride or not, but could your faction also call in maybe Bianca Belair because of the Montez connection?
I don't even know if they have, if they know each other's phone number. I don't know, man. I think that we definitely need to get Judgment Day. That's definitely on our radar. Of course, without a shadow of a doubt. That would be interesting. Anyway, there's a lot of females. Like I had this discussion with somebody before. Our women's wrestling is incredible. I mean, we're 6-7 women deep as far as like world champions. If you really think about it, we're about 5-7 deep, and all of them are incredible. So anyone we get from the women's division, whether it be a former world champion or somebody ready to crack that code and get up to that top five, top four position. Either way, it's going to be a really cool deal because we need some. Everybody else kind of has their women wrestler on their side. Mia Yim, she's over there at Mission. Everybody has someone. So if we had someone, we'd just make it stronger.
Amazing. Thank you so much for your time and best of luck for this weekend.
Right on, man.